So these are my WRX fans, my old ones, and I'm gonna see if I can retrofit them to the 240, and they're too long. So I'm gonna start cutting things off and see if I can shorten them down and see if they'll fit. So yeah. So I grind it as much as I can off the edges, not that edge, but these two edges. Cut off the coolant overflow mount, because these obviously stick over too much. So now, with the Filmex, or the fills, I have to cut there, and get closer. And then with these mounts, we got aluminum. We're gonna put it like that, bolt it in, drill holes for these to go into. And then up here, same thing, put that up there, bolt it in, and then find these holes and nuts and bolts through there. So I don't know, I might work. So this side over there, I need my oil cooler lines to sneak through there, so I can't have the fans hanging off that side. But I can hang it off this side a little bit. Let's see. Only like an inch. Worst comes to worst, I can just shave that off. Should I do a little bit more for the hose? Actually, this can come down.
No, because it'll have to go down when you mount it.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah.
Okay. Where are we? Probably a little bit more, huh?
Looks like it. Just notch it a little bit.
On that. Let's try that. Now we can start trying to mount it. gonna try. It's gonna be hard to get it mounted on the aluminum, and then close but not touching the radiator. So I'm wondering if we should bolt.
You have to bolt that up first.
Yeah. So should just eyeball it. Somewhere there. So we held it right above the weld so it wasn't resting on the weld, kind of like that. Just a little bit above. And put a level on it, make sure it was straight. And then just sharpied it. Now I'll just center punch it with a nail probably and drill it. Don't have a nail or a center punch. This is what's gonna happen. About center. Cool. Just for the time being, because we still have, we'll probably have to take it off to drill the other guys. Because we have lock washers for the top. Hey, it fits. It's so nerve wracking trying not to bend fins. Sturdy. Pin it tight. We put a piece of aluminum down to gap the radiator. We're gonna kind of eyeball this. Hopefully it works out. But so we don't want to touch the radiator, but we still want a good airtight so these fans can pull. So we marked it there and there. We're gonna drill and see what it looks like. There's me screw. Put it down into it. Looks pretty dead on.
Yeah, that's good.
I think this one's it. Ooh, whoa! It's like we know what we're doing. Look how tight a fitment that is. Trying to act not surprised, like I meant to do that.
Damn.
That's eyeballed.
Yeah, you might have to do it the other way so that those don't hit the bottom of the fan.
Maybe. These are leftover fans I have, so if this works, I got a fan setup for $30. Hardware and expensive Lowe's. Hardware and metal. Woo. Look at that. Beautiful. And it's not touching down there. Awesome.
Fuck yeah.
Threads are like dirty. I don't like going in bigger. Dude, why is it so perfect? Like, there's no movement in his eyeball. When we're done, we can round the edges up so it doesn't look so flat stock.
Yeah. Paint them black. Grab your screw. Alright, find a little drill bit and just mark it a little. Little mark. Do to mark it with a little drill bit. Ow. Burning my fucking leg off.
Through radiator. I actually like wrapping longer 6 mils. Well, that's gonna be difficult. It's almost like this top one should be steel, so it could weld. Or, I have to get more nuts, though.
Yeah, you just tighten that down like a peg. You know, tighten that thing.
You have to go to the store and get longer ones, more nuts.
And more for this side when we mount that side of the...
What do we got? We got more of those, see?
Those are M8s though, aren't they?
No.
Those are short M6s though, right?
They have long M6s and short M6s.
Oh.
Hopefully they don't hit the engine.
That sucks. It'll be close, but I think you might be fine.
So they're 2-speed. So they're 4. I think they're 4 wires. Or maybe 2 speeds in the ground.
High, low, and... No, they're 4 wires.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, there you go. There it is. Yeah.
The wire arm is high?
Yeah. There's 2 speeds. Low and high. I think let's keep it on high. These bits probably run out.
Grab that piece of piece of flat stock again.
Enough.
One, yeah.
So I still need to go to Lowe's and get more hardware for the top bolts. You can see they're drilled already, but and then I need longer bolts right there because they don't work. But look at this, I can't, it hangs over right there. I'll probably put a piece of foam there, but this side I cannot hang over, so I put it, you can see the fans are flush because I need to run oil lines through here. And look how close this is once I lean the radiator forward. I'll probably trim that just a little bit. But yeah, she fits. And hopefully once it's leaned forward, these big fans won't hit the motor.
So that was,
yeah.
That was stock.
Yeah, that's stock. And look how big these fans are. You could probably run these fans on an SR20 because the motor's back here, but straight six, yeah, right. So I just trimmed it, and beautiful clearance. So it's still not mounted 100%, but probably put foam in the areas where there's big gaps, or some kind of like block off plate, something. Yeah, it's in there. So, it's missing the hardware, but this is pretty much the finished product. You can see how far forward it's tilted. We have to still build the core support, which we're still gonna figure out how to do that. We're also gonna make a video doing that. But yeah, big little plastic fans off of 2004 WRX, my WRX. And hopefully they will clear the 1J. And have good cooling.